This week on the Brody File, we become the Rand Paul File. The Kentucky senator is taking the nation by storm, and we're at home with him and his wife, Kelly.
How do you handle all of the attention that he's been getting, that you both have been getting?
I would say I handle it by leaning hard on faith, friends, and family.
Could this man be the Republican nominee for president? A closer look at the Tea Party champion.
How would you describe yourself?
A guy that fits in quite better in a bowling alley than a black tie dinner.
Plus, a deeper look at Rand Paul's faith and how he lives it out.
For the country to get better, it needs more than just politicians. Politicians aren't enough. It needs a resurgence through churches, through revivals, through a spiritual cleansing of the people.
We head to Bowling Green, Kentucky for exclusive access with one of the rising stars in the Republican Party. Buckle up. A special edition of the Brody File is next. And welcome, everybody, to the Brody File Show. You know, we don't often devote entire shows to one person. It's extremely rare. All right, Kim Kardashian, sure, she's worthy. Maybe even the guy from the Gangnam Style video. This doesn't really happen often. All right, a little sarcasm dripping on Kardashian and that guy. But folks, Rand Paul, hey, he's a big deal. He's taken the GOP by storm. And when he talks, people listen. He sure did talk for a while during that classic filibuster on the Senate floor. It garnered him serious media attention. So look, during the next half hour, you are going to get a better sense of him and his wife, Kelly. They were gracious enough to let us spend a couple of days with them and their family. We rode with Rand Paul in the car. We followed him at local events. Heck, we even stalked him through a McDonald's. It's true. Now, let's be very clear here. Rand Paul is seriously considering running for president. And if played right, he does have the potential to build a strong coalition of libertarians, evangelicals, and yes, even some moderates. There are potholes ahead, for sure. But in the meantime, let's get to know him better. We're going to bring his wife Kelly in a little later in the show. But for now, here is some of our discussion with Rand Paul on everything from the state of the Republican Party to social issues, to his call for a spiritual cleansing of America.
What do you want people to know about you, about Rand Paul? I mean, there's been a lot of probably misconceptions out there. You know, the liberals want to paint you a certain way. Conservatives want to paint you a certain way. How should people, what should people know about you, the person and the politician?
Let's see. That I consider myself to be a family man and a good husband. I mow my own grass. I compost because I care about the environment. I plant trees in my yard. I'm currently trying to grow a giant sequoia in my yard. Mm-hmm. And that I truly care about trying to make the country a better place for everybody, you know, and to try to have such prosperity that I can come home from Washington and go back to being a doctor, because my first love's always been being a physician, doing eye surgery and helping people get their vision back.
Mm-hmm. You're not a heartless guy that they want to paint you out to be, the guy that's going to cut every federal program in the world.
No, Kelly always laughs and she said, tell him what you said about how you believe in $2.6 trillion worth of government. And it's true. It's not that I believe in no government. I just believe we should have the amount of government that we bring in taxes. Spend what comes in. That's an enormous amount of government, $2.6 trillion. Our problem is we spend $3.8 trillion and only bring in $2.6 trillion. $2.6 trillion is a lot of money, and you could do a lot of things, and it wouldn't be the no government, but we'd have to get rid of some of the wasteful parts of government.
You have mentioned in some of the speeches that you give and that this country needs a spiritual cleansing. And I'm curious what you mean by that, because, you know, especially the evangelicals that are watching this, or just conservative Christians, if you will, what does that mean to you? And I'm wondering about also, you know, as it relates to the culture and what's going on in today's culture.
The reason I say it is, one, I believe it, but two, I say it because I think it's important that people know that for the country to get better, it needs more than just politicians. Politicians aren't enough. It needs a resurgence through churches, through revivals, through a spiritual cleansing of the people. But it's not something that you're going to get from your politicians always. It's also, to me, a way of saying that the law or changing a particular law is not going to make us a better people, that comes from the people themselves.
Do you think you can ever get there in terms of being a supporter of same-sex marriage at some point? I know you believe in traditional marriage.
Right. I think that, we've got a long history with marriage. I'm not kind of willing to give up on it yet. And the family unit, above and beyond America and before America, the family unit's something that has been, come about for, thousands of years. We've had a family structure, and I think it's an important structure. Now, not everybody in the country is going to agree with me on that. There are people, and young people seem to be changing their opinions, but I think we should still be in favor of what we're in favor of, and that's that there is a traditional family unit, and that it's important. The law is going to be somewhat different in the sense that the where marriage is adjudicated, whether it's at the federal level or the state level. We've always had marriage certificates and we've had them at the state level. If we keep it that way, maybe we can still have the discussion go on without making the decision go all the way one way or all the way the other way. Because I think right now if we say, we're only going to have a federally mandated one man, one woman marriage, we're going to lose that battle because the country's going the other way right now. If we were to say each state can decide, I think a good 25-30 states still do believe in traditional marriage, and maybe we allow the debate to go on for another couple of decades and see if we can still win back the hearts and minds of people.
Do you believe social issues need to be somewhat minimized to win elections, if you will? Not that you're about necessarily politically winning elections, though that's a key component, but you talked about the GOP being moss-covered, and I just wonder if that's part of the situation here, that social issues, we need to kind of de-emphasize those, or what's your philosophy on that?
I think sort of the in-between is that it doesn't mean you can't elect and won't elect people who are socially conservative, but if that's the only issue, you do estrange some people. But what I'm saying is what you need is a candidate who does believe in your issues, who doesn't try to be something they're not, but also recognizes that what brings the country together and what people are trying to figure out is, how do I get my brother a job? How do I get my sister a job? How do I get the economy growing?
I know you can talk forever about this next question, but the relatively abridged version, which is the Christian just war theory. Is this something that you believe in pretty wholeheartedly here? And explain kind of your thinking on that.
Augustine talked about it. Other famous philosophers have talked about, a just war theory. And some of it means that war is typically in self-defense. I think that it is important that when we talk about war, that I think part of Republicans' problems, and frankly, to tell you the truth, some in the evangelical Christian movement, I think have appeared too eager for war. I think, when people come to me and they're lobbying for ratcheting up some sort of bellicose policy towards one country, even if it's a bad country, I tell them, when I read the New Testament and when I read about Jesus, I don't see him being involved. He wasn't really involved with the war of his days. In fact, people rebuked him for not being the king they wanted. They wanted somebody to stand up to the Romans. He stood up in a different sort of way, but he didn't organize coalitions and guerrilla bands and arm them. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't have, people who do want to defend against evil, bad forces around the world, but I think you need to remember that he was, he was Prince of Peace. We're talking about, blessed are the peacemakers, not blessed are the war makers.
2016, I'm not going to ask you about, this whole thing about are you going to run or you're not, because you don't know, obviously, or maybe you do. But anyhow, my simple question is, what are some of the thoughts going through your mind in terms of how you're going to arrive at that process or at that decision?
I have to ask my wife.
Well, let's get her back. That'll be the first thing.
It is. It's a family decision on deciding things like that. I think that most importantly right now is trying to figure out, what we can do to, help the economy, help the country. I think we, you know, really, we have this mountain of debt that's gathering that threatens our country. Mm-hmm. We have millions of people out of work. We have some people who have given up on looking for work. So we do have to, and I want to be part, I think I'm in a position to be part of the solution to try to help the country to grow again and to find its way. And I do want to be part of that. And so I think we'll sort that out over the next couple of years in figuring that out. But we don't have an answer yet on whether that means I'll do it still as a senator from Kentucky or whether it might be running for president. I haven't sorted that out yet.
All right, that's Rand Paul here on the Brody File. Before we head to break, we thought you might want to understand Rand Paul in a different light. So we had a chance to ask him about some of his favorite bands. Have a look. What's on the iPod, so to speak? What are some tunes? What are some bands? What gets you going? You gotta be honest. You'll be honest.
You know, how about the Rock Mafia?
Oh gosh.
Big Bang, that's a good song.
All right.
James Gang, Funk 49.
You are going on.
Amy Allen, you may never have heard of Amy Allen.
Sounds familiar. What's her genre?
I'd call her alternative rock, but okay. I don't know exactly. She's a good singer.
By the way, for the record, the Brody File is cranking up Barry Manilow in the car. I know, I just destroyed my entire career.
Off to this way, up high is where you'll see it.
All right, when we come back, the love of his life, Kelly Paul, lets us into her world. That's when the Brody File rolls on from Bowling Green, Kentucky.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys. Milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy. 6 baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
Help! If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
How would you describe yourself?
A guy that fits in probably better in a bowling alley than a black tie dinner.
Very nice, very nice. That's fair enough.
Somebody who tries to find common sense solutions to things as opposed to esoteric mumbo jumbo that nobody believes work.
That's Rand Paul describing himself as the Brody File, goes on the road with the senator from Kentucky. And welcome back, everybody, to this special Rand Paul edition of the Brody File. You know, while we were in the car with Rand Paul, we discussed a couple of other topics, including how faith, freedom, and virtue all go hand in hand. Take a look.
Many people who believe in very limited government and talk about freedoms to do this and freedoms to do that, it becomes misinterpreted by some people to believe, oh, you want people to do those things. Whereas freedom sometimes allows people to do things they shouldn't be doing, And in order for a civilization or a society to continue to exist with freedom, you need to have self-restraint.
You know, Rand Paul really doesn't wear his faith on his sleeve like other politicians such as Rick Santorum or Mike Huckabee. You're not going to hear him wax poetic about Jesus throughout the day. However, he is a Christian, and we had a chance to sit down and talk a little bit more about his faith.
What was it like growing up in Texas, you say, as a teenager? That personal relationship with Christ. I've talked to your father about this. It wasn't so much that he wore it on his sleeve all that much, but it was still an important part of his life. Is that kind of how, was that kind of like the upbringing, if you will?
Yeah, and I think that you can be a profoundly religious person but not tell everybody you meet. And if you are, maybe you're an evangelist and you're going to convert others, and maybe your life's mission isn't that, you know. And I guess mine has never been one that I felt like it was going to be my role to convert people. But I feel like it's an important part of not only, you know, my life, if not the most important part, but it's an important part of a civilization to have a faith.
Do you see your faith as integral to how you look at the world and how you shape your public policy?
Yeah, and I think one of the interesting things about government, and a lot of people don't talk about this, is that there's a philosopher, Bastiat, that talked about government, and one of his things that he mentioned and emphasized was that what is immoral for an individual to do is immoral for a government to do. And a lot of people don't think of that way. They know it's wrong to go and steal your neighbor's car, but they don't think it through to that it would be wrong for the government to go take one of your neighbor's cars also. That coveting people's wealth, envying people, being jealous, all those things are, we have admonitions against that on a religious and personal level, but they're not right for a collective or for a government to do either. And so I think that you have to have moral underpinnings. You have to know what is right and wrong. And if government's going to be the arbiter of law, and law tells you what you can and can't do, you need to know and have a good sense of what right and wrong is, and you need to know where that comes from. And I think that does come from your religious upbringing as well as your religious belief.
Rand Paul getting personal with his faith. All right, when we come back, the better half, Kelly Paul, Rand's wife, weighs in on her husband, her faith, and being in the spotlight. We're back in a moment.
Attention sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Rand Paul with his wife Kelly bird watching near their home in Bowling Green, Kentucky. Rand Paul will be the first to admit that she is indeed the better half. Welcome back, everybody, to this special edition of the Brody File Show as we go on the road and at home with Rand Paul. You know, if Rand Paul does decide to run for president in 2016, his wife may be one of his biggest assets. We spent a few days with Kelly Paul. She's smart, accomplished, pretty darn nice to boot. She met Rand Paul, by the way, at a backyard oyster roast, oy gewollt, after she finished college. The rest, as they say, is history. So, without further ado, meet Kelly Paul.
Goes from doctor to senator to who knows what's next. What do you think about everything just from the future and what God may have in store, and how do you handle all of the attention that he's been getting, that you both have been getting?
I would say I handle it by leaning hard on faith, friends, and family. We're really blessed to have large families, both of us, wonderful families. And I just can't tell you how many times that it's been difficult, and with him being gone, that I've looked down on my phone and I'll get a text message from Rand's sister Lori, and she sent me one of her favorite scriptures, or one of my brothers will call, or, you know, we have so many true friends that have been really good to us through this process. So those are, you know, our rocks, you know, just leaning hard on that, because it is hard to have your husband gone, and the criticism, and politics today are, it's a contact sport. It's very rough, and you do have to put yourself out there. I think it's worth it in the end for all the opportunities and to make a difference, and I believe that Rand can make a difference, but sometimes it can be lonely, and it's hard not to feel judged.
If he's thinking about running for president, and he goes, you know, there's just a 10% chance. There's just a 10% chance. You'd be pretty skeptical still, right? I mean, you know, it's going to be, I would think, kind of tough for you to get there, but there's something for you to think about, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. I think right now, as much as people try to talk about 2016, what Rand really is doing is still trying to advance the ideas that he feels passionate about. I mean, trying to make our country a better place, more prosperous, more free, the ideas of liberty, and, you know, reading the bills and adherence to the Constitution are what he's trying to do. And if those ideas continue to gain traction, then maybe we will. But I truly do try to live everything kind of one day at a time.
If you didn't have your belief in Jesus in your life, if that was just not part of your life, how does that change your life? What are you with Christ or without Christ, if you will?
I would say that my faith is a very sustaining thing, so that no matter what is going on in the world around you, you know that you can always turn to God, that, you know, to sustain you. You have your prayer life that is supporting, and that, you know, we're all very vulnerable in this life. Anything can happen any day, any moment. You can lose everything except for your soul and your relationship with God. It is the only permanent thing. So often people want to portray Christians as being harsh and judgmental, and they're not showing all the things that our churches are doing in our communities to help people, all of the things that people are trying to do to show Christ's love on earth by being helpful to other people and being truly trying to make the world a better place.
You know, we should also point out that Kelly Paul comes from a big-time military family, and so it makes sense that she has taken an active role in the Helping a Hero charity down in Kentucky. We actually spent some time with her. She was touring a house that was built specifically for a triple amputee vet and his wife. Helping folks like this, very important to Kelly.
I would think this has been something that's, you talked about, touched you, but boy, it's been quite an experience for you to be a blessing to someone, but yet you've been kind of blessed in the process too, I would think.
Absolutely. You just see the light in people. You see God working through people. People are so grateful sometimes to have the opportunity to express goodness and to give back to other people. And sometimes they're not asked, or they don't think of ways. And this is truly a collaborative effort on the part of our community.
Look, this is definitely a passion for Kelly Paul, and she's clearly making a difference along with a whole lot of other folks down there. We're going to have more on the Helping a Hero program in a future Brody File show. All right, when we come back, can you guess Rand Paul's favorite movie? The answer, next.
I mean, what's a top 10 Rand Paul movie?
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast. Then it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle. It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window. Yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo. You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
And welcome back to this special edition of The Brody File. Look, normally at the end of the show, as you know, we do our classic and very Jewish Oy Vey moment of the week. Not this week, though. Instead, we finish up this Rand Paul edition by bringing you some Rand Paul trivia. What is one of Rand Paul's favorite movies? Well, take a wild guess from a guy who is known around D.C. as Mr. Filibuster.
What's a top 10 Rand Paul movie?
Top 10 movie.
Are you like a Godfather guy, or are you like one of those, or?
Can I say Mr. Smith Goes to Washington?
Yeah. Yes, you can. Let me guess, you like that movie?
Yeah, I've always liked, the individual standing up against injustice.
Now, I noticed you didn't faint on the Senate floor or anything like Jimmy Stewart did in that movie there.
When he sings?
Yeah, he sings, and then all of a sudden at the end he has those papers and he falls down.
He was overacting a little bit.
Of course it's Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. Duh, we should have known better. Come on. That does it for this week. Until next time, everybody, God bless. Have a great week.